Is Bitcoin a threat to gold? Bitcoin's inconvenient truths. Some people were predicting Bitcoin would push through the $10,000 level before the end of the year. At the rate it's going, it may happen before the end of the month. Bitcoin is on a roll. The cryptocurrency broke $9,000 over the Thanksgiving holiday and quickly pushed up to $9,700. There are also increasing signs of mainstream adoption. Kami Group plans to list Bitcoin futures beginning in mid-December, and Coinbase says it added more than $100,000 new users over the Thanksgiving holiday. Some analysts look at all the action in the world of cryptocurrency and predict the demise of gold. But there are plenty of reasons to believe gold will be just fine. Last month, Jim Rickards called the raging gold versus Bitcoin argument a phony debate, because cryptocurrencies and precious metals are fundamentally different things. From my perspective, you might as well discuss gold versus watermelons or bicycles versus Bitcoin. In other words, it's a phony debate. I agree that gold and Bitcoin are both forms of money, but they go their own ways. There's no natural relationship between the two, what traders call a basis. The gold/Bitcoin basis trade does not exist. The managing director of Australia's biggest gold mining company recently made a similar point. Sandeep Biswas called Bitcoin a new age currency entering into the mix with old age currencies, but he doesn't view it as a threat to the value of gold. A store of value, and maybe I'm too much of a traditionalist, in my view has to be something you can feel and touch. So a store of value, like gold, or it used to be silver or other precious metals, in my view is a true store of value. Because it doesn't matter what happens, if you've got your arm around that gold that's yours, for example. The thing with Bitcoin and other currencies, it's got to be backed by something, so currencies are backed by government. That's fine. Bitcoin is backed by security or its uniqueness. So I see Bitcoin as more of a currency than a store of value, such as a precious metal such as gold. So I don't really see, and I know there's a lot of talk about it, but I don't see Bitcoin as a fundamental threat to the value of gold. It's just introducing a new age currency into the mix of old age currencies. It's easy to disregard somebody like Biswas and blow him off because he's old school and has a vested interest in gold, but it's important to consider his argument on its merits. He's not saying Bitcoin has no value. He's just pointing out that cryptos and precious metals have some fundamental differences, namely that gold and silver are real tangible things with utility beyond their use as money. Biswas said he's optimistic that gold will continue to increase in value. He said the growth in global wealth, particularly in India and China, coupled with tightening supplies will drive gold higher in the future. And then the other thing going for gold, and it comes back to deeper ore bodies, it's getting harder to find. So you've got something that's valuable, it is a genuine store of value, it's physical, you've got people becoming wealthier and it's becoming scarcer and scarcer. That I think long term bodes well for gold, but in the short term it can be volatile. As we have said before, you don't have to take an either position on Bitcoin and precious metals. In the world of expanding wealth, there is certainly room for more than one kind of asset. You can have both. In fact, it might be a good idea to have both. At Scheif Gold, we recommend a diversified approach to investing in Bitcoin. Buying gold and silver is a great way to diversify your cryptocurrency portfolio. You can even buy gold and silver with Bitcoin. In the world of investing, it's never wise to put all of your eggs in one proverbial basket. Diversifying your cryptocurrency portfolio with precious metals can help mitigate some of the potential downsides and put you in an overall stronger financial position. Bitcoin's inconvenient truths, the silence is deafening. Dave Kranzler. Dave Kranzler says that some of the most vocal protesters of COMEX gold and silver futures are silent on Bitcoin, and the silence is deafening. Here's why. Gold is instantly and optically recognizable as money. You don't have to explain it. Bitcoin and special drawing rights, SDR, like a bad joke, have to be explained. Many cryptologists from the start gave up trying to explain Bitcoin and just sell it as virtual gold, which is de facto fake gold. Dan Popescu, investment consultant. Numerous inconvenient truths are conveniently ignored by Bitcoin/cryptocurrency promoters. Not the least of which is that the fact that the original concept for cryptographic currency was envisioned by the NSA. I guess it's convenient to assume the NSA developed this concept and then put it out there for the private sector to develop. Sure, that makes sense. A rapid rise in price does not validate an investment concept. Dozens of .com stocks went from simple websites to multi-billion dollar market caps and back to zero in the late 1990s. Until proven otherwise by the long test of time, Bitcoin could be another product of a fiat money printing bubble that is 100x the size of the money bubble that fueled the .com bubble. Gold and silver have withstood the test of 5,000 years. Bitcoin has less than 3,000 days of time testing. Be leery of the serial promoters who have dropped their previous advocacy of gold and silver like a hot potato to become religiously zealous salesmen of Bitcoin. These were often among the most raucously vocal in their protest of the use of COMEX gold and silver futures to manipulate the market price. Yet, their silence on the introduction of Bitcoin futures hurts my ears. The bulwark promotion of Bitcoin is that it is a decentralized form of money that exists outside of government control. But is it really? I dare say the rollout of COMEX Bitcoin futures, as regulated by the CFTC, certainly smells like the implementation of official intervention. Those who previously protested gold/silver futures must not deny this fact. Perhaps more troublesome is the embedded forms of counterparty risk endemic to the system which creates Bitcoin. Anything that exists in cyberspace is vulnerable to hacking. This is a fact that has yet to be invalidated. Circling back to the NSA white paper referenced above, can anyone out there truly claim the expertise required to deny that the NSA, or any other major sovereign intelligence agency, does not have the ability to corrupt the blockchain? To be sure, cryptocurrencies are subject to network or infrastructure risk during a crisis. Unequivocally, cryptos are subject to government regulation. Speaking of which, if I were a Bitcoin advocate, it would bother me that Western governments go out of their way to hide their interest in gold as a monetary asset, yet they openly embrace cryptocurrencies. Perhaps when the BIS declares Bitcoin or Ethereum to be a Basel III Tier 1 central bank asset like gold, I'll have a change of heart. The price of Bitcoin has experienced a remarkable run in price this year. Of course, the same could have been said for Dutch tulip bulbs from late 1636 to late 1637. Most of the traders are chasing the price higher, with little to no understanding of the object they are chasing with their money, in hopes that someone at a later point in time will come along and pay a higher price to them. Even worse, these price chasers have placed undying faith in the analysis of Bitcoin coming from the same con artists with whom they placed religious faith in the analysis of precious metals. Also, up to this point there's been an absence of two-way price discovery for Bitcoin. Once the COMEX futures are rolled out, it will introduce, albeit in an unwelcome format, a provocative method to sell Bitcoin on margin. The use of margin is the hallmark of a fiat currency-based fractional banking system, the very nature of which Bitcoin supposedly repudiates. The Bitcoin longs will face the same unlimited supply potential of paper Bitcoin that precious metals investors have endured for decades. Make no mistake, I'm not trying to derail anyone's interest in Bitcoin or cryptocurrencies. And I'll be the first to admit that it's likely the price will go a lot higher from here. But if the issues I raise here are indeed legitimate, how do you know when it will be the right time to sell? That is to say, while the parabolic rise in Bitcoin has been largely continuous, any number of events could occur that would force the price rediscovery to be a step function. It's all wine and roses on the way up, but at what price will there be a bid for you to relieve yourself of your position? predict the demise of gold. But there are plenty of reasons to believe gold will be just fine. Last month, Jim Rickards called the raging gold versus Bitcoin argument a phony debate, because cryptocurrencies and precious metals are fundamentally different things. From my perspective, you might as well discuss gold versus watermelons or bicycles versus Bitcoin. In other words, it's a phony debate. I agree that gold and Bitcoin are both forms of money, but they go their own ways. There's no natural relationship between the two, what traders call a basis. The gold/Bitcoin basis trade does not exist. The managing director of Australia's biggest gold mining company recently made a similar point. Is Bitcoin a threat to gold? Bitcoin's inconvenient truths. Some people were predicting Bitcoin would push through the $10,000 level before the end of the year. At the rate it's going, it may happen before the end of the month. Bitcoin is on a roll. The cryptocurrency broke $9,000 over the Thanksgiving holiday and quickly pushed up to $9,700. There are also increasing signs of mainstream adoption. Kami Group plans to list Bitcoin futures beginning in mid-December, and Coinbase says it added more than $100,000 new users over the Thanksgiving holiday. Some analysts look at all the action in the world of cryptocurrency and point. Sandeep Biswas called Bitcoin a new age currency entering into the mix with old age currencies, but he doesn't view it as a threat to the value of gold. A store of value, and maybe I'm too much of a traditionalist, in my view has to be something you can feel and touch. So a store of value, like gold, or it used to be silver or other precious metals, in my view is a true store of value. Because it doesn't matter what happens, if you've got your arm around that gold that's yours, for example. The thing with Bitcoin and other currencies, it's got to be backed by something, so currencies are backed by government. That's fine. Bitcoin is backed by security or its uniqueness. So I see Bitcoin as more of a currency than a store of value growth and global wealth, particularly in India and China, coupled with tightening supplies will drive gold higher in the future. And then the other thing going for gold, and it comes back to deeper ore bodies, it's getting harder to find. So you've got something that's valuable, it is a genuine store of value, it's physical, you've got people becoming wealthier and it's becoming scarcer and scarcer. That I think long term bodes well for gold, but in the short term it can be volatile. As we have said before, you don't have to take an either position on Bitcoin and precious metals. In the world of expanding wealth, there is certainly room for more than one kind of asset. You can have both. In fact, it might be a good idea, such as a precious metal such as gold. So I don't really see, and I know there's a lot of talk about it, but I don't see Bitcoin as a fundamental threat to the value of gold. It's just introducing a new age currency into the mix of old age currencies. It's easy to disregard somebody like Biswas and blow him off because he's old school and has a vested interest in gold, but it's important to consider his argument on its merits. He's not saying Bitcoin has no value. He's just pointing out that cryptos and precious metals have some fundamental differences, namely that gold and silver are real tangible things with utility beyond their use as money. Biswas said he's optimistic that gold will continue to increase in value. He said